Dynamic Reality CR30, also known as Naomi Wu's 3D print mill. This was made in collaboration with Carl Brown from Neck3D. Carl Brown has made a huge belt printer, which is called the White Knight. That was the inspiration for this machine. The awesome thing about this printer is that the print head is tilted at an angle of 45 degrees, and instead of a standard bed, it has a belt. So it's capable of printing larger than the printer itself. It will just print on continuously, so you can print infinitely large, as they say.
Infinite Z.
Infinite Z.
Infinite, in fact.
Infinite. How do you make something infinitely large? Fusion 360 doesn't support infinite dimensions. How do you create an infinitely large part? It will create an infinitely large 3D print file. This thing is shipped with an 8GB SD card. Not an infinitely large SD card. I want to make full use of the space that has been given to me. So, I want to print infinitely large things. On December 22, Chris Taylor had this exact problem. He made a file larger than the slicer supported. He ended up with a file of 53 megabytes. 53 megabytes of commands in plain text are a lot of commands. In order to print infinitely large, there must be some kind of recurring sequence in there. So I replied to that saying that I bet that the G-code itself must have some repetition into it. So you must find a pattern within your file itself. But how do you find patterns? I know that it's possible to find patterns when using substances. So I didn't find any patterns. So I had to come up with a different idea. How do you tell a computer to find a pattern and you don't know the size of that pattern? So just give it a file and let the computer find the pattern. So I was quite close to losing my mind, but I think I have found a way to find a pattern within an array from which you don't know the size of the pattern. In order to explain this correctly, I need some coffee.
Coffee?
Okay, I try to explain everything using some colors, a top-down camera and some fancy animation, but none of it matters because it doesn't work. I was able to find some simple patterns within a simple array, but the G-code of tens of thousands of lines isn't simple. Turns out that there are minute differences between each layer, so I was just unable to find a pattern. I just started over and I came up with the proper pattern recognizer. The proper pattern recognizer is an advanced tool that you can use to find patterns within your G-code properly. It has a sick UI. Oh. Okay, let's see if this proper pattern recognizer is any good. I've made the software in LabVIEW. LabVIEW is a graphical programming interface in which you can build your software using blocks and lines and structures. The reason why I'm using LabVIEW is because I'm a LabVIEW programmer and I know my way around here. If you want to use LabVIEW yourself, you can download the community edition, which is free. This is the user interface, and if I'm going to run it, I can load G-code. This G-code is the G-code that I've printed this chain with. If I'm not going to fast load it, you can see that it will load each individual layer, and it builds it up in here in this 3D view. But this takes quite long. Can zoom in holding the shift button. So, and this is only for reference. So if I'm going to fast load this thing, then we have the whole chain here. And because this is a cube, it's a bit out of proportion, but this shows basically the shape. But the interesting thing is happening in this analyze tab, because within this tab, we can see the actual pattern within this G-code file. And I think that this is quite dope. What we are seeing here are all the X movements added up to each other. And at the horizontal axis, we see the layer number. This is the whole file from layer number 0 to 480. And you can already see that there are minute differences between each layer. So this made it quite difficult to find a pattern automatically at that lowest level within the file itself. And a funny thing about this chain is that all these links are perpendicular to each other, but within this pattern, they have the same pattern. So this is chain link 1 and this is chain link 2, but this is perpendicular to this one. We can choose between the X movements, the Y movements, the extruder movements, and the X minus Y. You can select the one which looks the best. We can just drag this and select the point on which you want to loop. It doesn't necessarily have to be at a valley like this. I can also start from, well, somewhere here. This is an easy reference point, so I will pick one here and the other one. So this is one link and this will be two links. And if you want to make sure if you are close, then we can also zoom in and we can do some fine tuning here. And I think that this looks good. So we have a starting G-code. This will be our loop and our ending G-code. And this shows the start and end G-code lines. So the loop starts at line 17,710. So if we have selected our points, we can select how many loops we want. And I will just run it continuously. So if I press the loop button, I can save a new G-code file. So if you're going to take a look into Notepad++, what it actually has done, if you go to line 17,710, it has added the line M808L. What I'm doing here is exactly the same as Carl Brown did in his video about making an infinitely long chain, but he did it manually. And I'm doing the same thing, but automated with LabVIEW. If you go to line 32,408, then we can see the same M808 command. Between this M808 command and the previous, it will loop, and in this case forever. Carl Brown explains that perfectly in his video, and I've used that knowledge to make this loop generator here. Thanks, Carl, for your information. It helped a lot with making this possible. In order for this to work, we need the newest firmware on the 3D print mill. I just updated the firmware. This camera is making a time lapse, and hopefully this will result in a very long chain. But maybe it can also fail. I have no idea, so fingers crossed. At this moment, it's already longer than the original chain itself. So that means that my software is working. Now I'm able to just select the loop, let it run for. I've let this thing run for a while. In order to stop it, I can just turn it off and remove that last link. But with that newest firmware and that M808 command, there's a new menu entry which says end repeat loops. And I can just select that and it will finish the G-code properly. So let's just do that. And now it will finish the rest of the G-code and I will have a quite a long chain. Well, I'm quite curious how long this chain actually is. Oh Jesus. Oh man. Okay. Nice. I think that this proves that my software works. Other things that I would like to try with this is for instance the chainmail by Flowalistic. I loaded that and you will get this pattern. And it looks quite distinctive, so I bet you can just do the same thing but get a large sheet of chainmail. How cool is that? You can also use it for printing, let's say, profiles. So if you need a 2020 profile, you can just print it and let it. I've got some cool projects in mind for this thing. For instance, I want to 3D print a guitar, and I also want to design my own airsoft gun, and this printer enables those kinds of crazy projects. So I'm really looking forward to that. If you don't want to miss that and you haven't subscribed already, consider doing so. Thanks a lot for watching, and if you like this video, then hit that like button, and if you have any questions, just leave a comment. And I wish you a great day and see you in the next video. Bye.